Today we will be looking at a question that many have explored and have found no answer that is really convincing. This question is one that everyone thinks of and ponders, especially when they lose a loved one. The question we look at for today: what happens when I die? The Bible says that those who believe in Jesus are ushered into His presence. Reading from Scripture, John chapter 14, verse 3. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. The Bible is not silent about death. It tells us that God has set eternity into the hearts of men, which means that in every human soul, there is a God-given awareness that there is something more to life than this transient world. This means that we have an innate knowledge that there is something more to life than what we can see or what we experience in the here and now. The Apostle Peter calls us strangers and aliens in this world. The Bible reveals that God is a holy God, and every man has sinned and falls short of the glory of God, which means there is a big gulf between God and man. And man attempts to reach God through their own efforts. It could be living a good life, or holding on to some practice or philosophy, or even living a religion or practicing a religion. But none of these human efforts enables man to reach God, because it says in the Bible that all our righteous acts are like filthy rags. Holiness and sin cannot exist together. It's like mixing water and oil. They are insoluble. And when we are sinful, it does not qualify us to a holy kingdom. It takes us to a place of eternal fire or eternal hell, as the Bible describes it. However, the Bible is not without hope. It leaves us with the hope that the whole message of the Bible communicates God's love, wherein He intervened and sent His one and only Son, Jesus Christ, to earth to live a perfect life and die a terrible death on a cross so that we could have eternal life in heaven. Now Jesus's death paid for our sins and thus bridged the gulf between God and man, and thereby He made a way for us to live into eternal destiny. This is the hope for all those who believe in Jesus, that one day we will be spending eternity with Him. Everyone who is born dies, and facing the Creator is inevitable. Let's be sure of our eternal destiny and all that awaits us in that glorious kingdom. Let's pray. Father God, we thank You for the hope that we have in You, not just now, but even after we die. We thank You for preparing a place for us through Your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank You because You loved the world so much that You gave Your Son to die for us so that we could spend our eternity with You, rejoicing and praising and worshiping You. We pray that even as we look forward, eager to that day, that we will live in hope of our eternal destiny. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.